Hello, my name is Dr. Thompson. You've been diagnosed with appendicitis. We are showing you this video because your doctors and nurses think you might want to know about a research study you may qualify for. This video will help you learn more about the study. Right now, surgery is the most common treatment for appendicitis in the United States. But six studies that were done in Europe show that most people with appendicitis can be treated successfully with medicines called antibiotics instead of having to get surgery. We want to learn more about the difference between these two treatments. Studies show that both treatments for appendicitis are safe and effective. What we don't know are the answers to questions that really matter to patients, such as how quickly will I feel back to normal and which treatment will get me back to work or school sooner. A study to find the answers is being done at a number of top hospitals across the country, including the one you're in today. This type of study is called a randomized trial. It's one of the best ways to test if one treatment is better than the other. Randomized trials help us know how to best treat future patients. If you choose to take part in this study, you will have an equal chance of getting either antibiotics or surgery to treat your appendicitis. We will also ask you to answer surveys over the next 2 years. Your answers will help us understand how your treatment has worked for you. Your doctors and nurses will manage your pain and do everything they can to get you better as quickly as possible. This is true no matter which treatment you get or whether or not you want to be part of this study. Your doctor is an expert on treating appendicitis. We asked you to watch this video because your doctor thinks either antibiotics or surgery will work for you. You might be worried about getting a newer treatment if you participate, but studies have shown that either treatment is safe and can work. It is important that all populations are represented, including women and minority groups. If you take part in the study, you will be helping millions of people like you who get appendicitis in the future by helping us understand which treatment is better. You will also be helping us understand who will benefit from one treatment or the other. Please know that your name and other information will be kept private. Let's talk about what having appendicitis means. The appendix is a small finger-sized tube attached to the large intestine. When you have appendicitis, it means that your appendix is swollen from an infection. The swelling causes pain and may make you feel sick. Appendicitis is very common. Now let's talk about the two treatments in this study, surgery and antibiotics. First, we'll explain surgery. Surgery to take out the appendix is called an appendectomy. Most times, an appendectomy is done with 3 or 4 tiny incisions or cuts on the belly. This is called laparoscopic surgery. Sometimes surgery is done with a single larger incision. This is called open surgery. During surgery, the appendix will be removed from your body. Then the cuts on your belly will be closed with staples or stitches. After surgery, most patients go home by the next day. Some stay in the hospital an extra day or longer. If you have surgery, you will be sent home with pain medicine to take as needed. Most patients return to normal activities after about 1 week. Next, let's talk about antibiotics. Antibiotics are medicines that fight infection. If we treat your appendicitis with antibiotics and you feel well enough to go home from the emergency room, you might not have to stay in the hospital at all. Or you may stay in the hospital for a day or two, depending on how you feel. First, the antibiotics will be given to you through a small plastic tube in your vein. This tube is called an IV. While you are getting antibiotics, you may also get medicines to treat pain and nausea. After you go home, you must keep taking antibiotic pills for a total of 10 days. It's important that you take the full 10 days of antibiotics, even if you feel better. We will give you pain medicine to take home with you that you can take as needed. Now let's talk about the benefits of surgery. Surgery for appendicitis removes the cause of the infection. After your appendix is removed, you will not get appendicitis again. About 1 out of 10 patients has a problem after an appendectomy. Most of these problems are minor, such as a skin infection where the incisions were made. Serious risks after surgery include infections or bleeding inside the belly, or very rarely leaking from the intestine where the appendix was attached. These more serious problems do not happen very often. If they do happen, another surgery might be needed to fix them. Let's talk about the benefits of antibiotics. If antibiotics work, you will not need to have surgery. You may be able to return to work or school faster and have less pain and problems than if you have surgery. You also may be able to go home from the emergency room if you're feeling better instead of having to stay overnight in the hospital. The most common risks of antibiotics are upset stomach, diarrhea, and skin rashes. Serious problems from taking antibiotics are very rare. The European studies tell us that most patients who take antibiotics will not need surgery, but about 1 out of 4 may have more problems with their appendix and need to have surgery later. Some will need surgery shortly after the antibiotics because they are not improving. Others may get appendicitis again months or years later. The studies also show that patients have good results up to 1 year after their first hospital visit, both after surgery and after taking antibiotics. We hope this video has helped you learn about appendicitis and our research study. We also hope that you will consider taking part in the study. Doing so will help future patients with appendicitis and their doctors choose the treatment that's right for them. If you choose to take part, we'll send you a check for each survey you complete to thank you for your time. Our research coordinator will give you more information and ask if you are willing to take part in the study. Your doctor can also answer any questions you have. No matter what you choose, we will take care of you, control your pain, and help you to get better. We wish you a speedy recovery. Thank you.